So my name is Diana Franklin, and I manage the Centre for German Jewish Studies, Weidenfeld Institute at the University of Sussex. And I'd like to tell you what we are doing about Holocaust Memorial Day this year. Our event will take place on Wednesday, the 1st of February, from 2 o'clock till 6 o'clock. That's a little bit later than the national day of the 27th of January, because we like students to be back on campus. This will be our first in-person event since 2020, and it will be the first time our new Vice Chancellor, Professor Sasha Rose Neal, will be welcoming everyone to the university since her appointment in August 2022. The theme for 2023 is the impact that the Holocaust had on ordinary people, so that survival was extraordinary. As Elie Wiesel wrote, "What is abnormal is that I am normal, that I survived the Holocaust and went on to love, to talk, to write, to have toast and tea and live my life. That is what is abnormal." We're honoured that Manfred Goldberg, who is 92 years old, will speak to us about his experiences during the Holocaust. I saw Manfred speaking on a BBC programme entitled Seven Portraits, Surviving the Holocaust, when he was painted by Clara Drummond. The paintings were commissioned by King Charles when he was Prince of Wales. Each of the portrait sitters sought refuge in Britain after the war, and each has been honoured for services to Holocaust awareness and education. Manfred was born in 1930 in Kassel in central Germany. In December 1941, Manfred, his mother and younger brother were deported by train from Germany to the Riga ghetto in Latvia. He will talk about his time in the ghetto, followed by time in the Stutthof concentration camp in Poland. The camp was abandoned just days before the war ended, and Manfred and other prisoners were sent on a death march. Manfred was finally liberated on the 3rd of May, 1945. After a break, we'll show a film called Reckonings, directed by Roberta Grossman. It's a groundbreaking exploration of the ethical dilemmas posed by coming to terms with guilt. The release of Reckonings in 2022 marks the 70th anniversary of the Luxembourg Agreement, reached on September the 10th, 1952, in which the German government agreed to pay reparations to both survivors and the State of Israel. It was signed by Konrad Adenauer, then Chancellor of Germany, and Moshe Sharet, who 2 years later became Israel's second prime minister. They met in secret to negotiate the unthinkable: compensation for the survivors of the largest mass genocide the world had ever known. Survivors were in urgent need of help, but how could reparations be determined for the unprecedented destruction of a people? How could money be accepted without appearing to sell atonement? Professor Konstantin Goschler, who has written two books on the subject of reparations and who is interviewed in the film, will be with us for a discussion of this difficult issue. Please log on to our website to register so you can hear Manfred Goldberg tell his story and watch and join in the discussion about Reckonings. You can Google HMD Sussex 2023 to find the link, or note down the link shared by Latest TV. And if you can't make it on the day, our event will be recorded and available from our website afterwards. You can also register for two further events during the week of February at Sussex. These explore the potential of digital media to preserve Holocaust memory. On the evening of Thursday, 2nd of February at 6, there'll be a screening of the documentary Tachlis, The Heart of the Matter, which follows protagonist Yair Harel as he attempts to uncover his family history and design a computer game about his grandmother's experiences during the Holocaust. And on Saturday, 4th of February, there'll be a one-day workshop for UK-based teachers and Holocaust educators on international approaches to Holocaust education. Please do register on our website for our Holocaust Memorial Day, and for the other two events, you'll find links on the screen. Thank you.